Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Hall of Fame. Now you may be wondering why there's a Hall of Fame for Universe Mode. Well, I'll tell you why. As the chairman of WWE Triple H, it is my job to immortalize some of the most influential men in this 275 episode series to this point. We have only had 5 men ever enter the Hall of Fame of Universe Mode. When the Hall of Fame was created, it was back in season 3. Ever since then, every single man is out to prove not just that he is the man, but that he deserves to be immortalized. That is the case for the men that have already been inducted and for the men that will be inducted. Back in season 3, we had the one and only man from the class of season 3, Mr. Samuel. He defined what it took to earn and immortalize yourself by putting his career on the line. Then in season 4, we had The Undertaker, one of the most influential performers in wrestling, be inducted. Along with him came Slim Reaper, one half of the legendary Hitmen of Universe Mode, and has delivered some of the greatest matchups and tag team performances in Universe Mode as well. Following him is one of the baddest heels in the world, Harvey. He's not only raised the bar, but he's set the bar in terms of what it takes to call yourself the man and be the most ruthless of them all. Then came the headliner, the other pillar of the 3 originals. Next to Mr. Samuel now was immortalized Tyler the King Wolf. All 5 of those men have gone down into the sunset as some of the all-time greats. And as those great gladiators head off, there will be one more joining them tonight. This man, I have the honor and the privilege to induct with one match that made him a legend. In one match, he became an icon, and I saw him as the future. And he proved that you don't need to be the biggest, baddest man in the world to be called the best. This man started off his career becoming the 2nd ever NXT Tag Team Champions with Sin Cara. This man became iconic when he secured the NXT Championship at NXT TakeOver Toronto back in season 1 by pinning the best in the world in one of the greatest Iron Man matches of all time. He put on great matches in that title reign with the likes of Kane, shockingly. Put on great matches with Cody Rhodes. And put on a phenomenal performance at the end of his reign with guys like Class Parr in that match. He would then go up to the main roster, and let's just say, despite the short resume, allow me to continue. He became Hardcore Champion in season 5. He also won the United States title not once, not twice, not 3 times, but 4 times. This man defined what it took to become the man of SmackDown Live, as he never once jumped ship to Raw or left them hanging high and dry. He stuck to the blue brand all the way through. And this man, despite all of this, has only won the WWE Championship once, and never once got to defend it because of injury. Now, despite that list, why he's being inducted is because he is not only 4-0 at WrestleMania. It is because of almost every single match he's ever been in. It feels impactful, it feels important, and he delivers every single night. He is one of the best cruiserweights to never hold the purple strap and never needed to wear it. He is one of the most decorated in terms of match quality and match performance, and deserves the nickname in Universe Mode as the best technical wrestler. Because there is no man that can hold a candle to his match quality in terms of consistently delivering every time. And not only does he raise the expectations of Universe Mode, but he sets it. And that is why he's being inducted tonight. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, it is my honor, as the chairman of Universe Mode, to welcome the world to the newest and the sixth member of the Hall of Fame and the class of Season 5's Hall of Fame. It is the best technical wrestler in the world, Yuri Yamashita. You're here, boy.